Hi everyone, it's Sam from SiteMate. In this video, we're going to take a look at the templates section inside of the Dashpivot mobile app. You can see here that I've got the app open and we're in the templates section. We know that because the template icon, which is this page and pen, has been highlighted in blue and underlined. And we can see on the screen, we have a list of all of the templates that have been added to this particular project team. And you'll notice that they're organized into different categories. We have commercial and safety and environment and so on. This is all managed via the website, but it makes it really easy to organize the templates together to make it really easy to find them when we have quite a large number of templates. So you can see here that we're in the All tab at the moment, and we do have these breakers between the different tabs. So for convenience, you can just sort of scroll through all of the records, all of the templates. But we also have the tabs along the top. So if we tap on commercial or safety or environmental, it's only showing us those templates that exist under that tab or have been added to that tab. But if we go back to the All tab here, you can see that we have a series of templates, and there's actually two types of templates. We have timeline style templates, which have this icon, a series of horizontal bars, such as this site diary here. And we have workflows, which have some intertwined arrows. And we're going to take a look at both in this video. The main difference is that with timeline style templates, all of the forms are organized by day. So we can see day by day by day, all of the forms in a chronological timeline. With the workflow, it's a bit different. All of the forms are organized into columns, basically different statuses. And in order for the forms to move from one side to the other, it follows a predefined process, which again is configured via the website. So let's start off by looking at this timeline template here, this site diary. And if we click on it, we can see all of the records that have been filled out so far. And because it's a timeline, everything is stored in date order. So we have the most recent up the top from December 7th. And then if we scroll down, December 4th, the 3rd, 2nd, the 1st, and so on. So we can continue scrolling down and we're just going to go further and further back in time. So the oldest forms are at the bottom and the most recent ones are at the top. If we want to fill out a new form, we click this green button here with the plus on it, and it will pull up a fresh new form for us. And we can start to fill it out. So we have a date field at the top, and then we have some multiple choice questions. Then we have a text field. And we won't fill out the whole thing in this video, but I just want to give you a sense of what it's like to fill out one of the forms. We have an add photo button, so I'm just going to tap on that. And there's a few options, but in this video, we're going to click open camera. Take a photo of this this plant that we have here. And maybe we want to mark that up. Click done. Go to the next screen and we can add a description and tag it as we normally would using the photo section of Dashpivot. And we'll click save. It will save this photo into this form. So we can see here that we've got that photo there. And then if we scroll down, we also have a table where we can add in some entries, and then we have a signature at the bottom. So we'll just sign that. And once we're happy with all of the content that's been filled out in this form, we'll click the Save button up the top. And that will save that record into Dashpivot. And if we give it just a moment, we get this green tick here. And what that means is, now that it's been uploaded into Dashpivot, anyone who's got access to this project team and to this template can now access the record that we've just created. So if you've got other team members who are on different sites or in another area, who are working on their phones or their tablets, they'll now be able to access these records. And anyone who is working in an office somewhere, who's maybe at their computer, would be able to log in and access the same records. So everything's being synced in real time. And I'll just show you on the website, if we just refresh the page, we can see the record that we've just created from December 8th at 3:33 p.m., which is exactly the time that we created our record here. So we're looking at the same thing just on the website, and we can open it up, and you can see all the information that we entered. You can even see the photo that we took and marked up here on the website. So everything syncs very quickly with the Dashpivot app, and it makes communicating information across your projects or your sites really quick. So that's the timeline template. The last thing I'll show you from this screen is that you can go back and modify the forms that you've created. So let's take our example up the top here. If we tap on it, it opens up the form right where we left off. So we've got all that same info that we put in before. Maybe we make a slight change. And once we've made that change, you'll see that the save button then highlights again, and then we can save that change if we want. The last thing from this screen to point out is that we have some additional actions down the bottom. So we have this blue button with the three dots. If we tap on that, we've got a couple of actions that we can perform. The first is to send this form as a PDF to someone, just via email. We've got the option, the second option, to clone this form, and it will just duplicate all of the information from the form that we're cloning into a new form. It'll clone everything except any signatures, which makes it much faster to fill out, you know, a lot of repetitive information. And then, of course, we've got the third option, which is just to delete the form. So we're going to save those changes now, and it will start to sync that up with the website as well. But while it's doing that, we're just going to go back, and we're going to go and take a look at the workflow template that we have. So we're actually going to take a look at this one here, this excavation permit. So when we tap on that, you can see that we have a slightly different interface. Workflows organize all of the forms into columns. So this is actually the first column, permit creator. We can see that there's one form sitting in there. But if we scroll across, you can see that there's actually several columns, four in total, and we have a form in each of the columns except the second one. So the mechanics of creating a form works exactly the same. So we click the green plus button, and it creates a new form. We can go through and start to fill it out. This one has a number of checks that can be filled out, but eventually we're going to arrive at what we call an approval signature. And I'll show you how that works in just a moment. Before I click to sign it, I just want to show you that if I save the form without signing anything, the form will sit in the very first column of the workflow. And the mechanism to move it from column one to column two is going to be to sign that first approval signature. So we're going to go back into it. So we're just going to tap on the form again to make a change. We're going to scroll down, and assuming that we've filled out everything that we need to that's above the approval signature, including any required fields, we can click the green button to sign to approve. It will stamp our signature on here, and it will actually lock all of the information above. So you'll notice that we can't actually make any changes anymore. We can't tap any of these buttons. They're all disabled. Even the ones that we've filled out, we can't make any changes here. And if we click save, you see that the form has actually now moved across to the next column, and it's now just syncing that change that we've made. So, I guess the main thing to understand here is that it's the approval signatures that move the forms between the columns. So if we wanted to now move it from this column to the third column, the active permits column, we'd need to reopen this form, find the next approval signature, and sign it to move it across. But other than that, the mechanics work exactly the same. And that sums up this video. We've gone through the templates, we've covered how to find templates, we've covered how to fill them out, and we've covered the differences between timeline-style templates and workflows. If you have any questions, you can reach our team via live chat, either via the Dashpivot website, or via the app. And as always, thanks for watching.